Hey, hi Per, great to have you here. And as a great friend and as well as Intune Engineering, a member in the field as well, great to have you here. And as author of our book, Mastering Intune.
Hello, Christian. Nice to see you again. It's been way too long.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing you in roughly 6 to 8 weeks in Denmark. But before I see you there, Intune Suite and Windows 365 have been huge asks from our customers right in the field. So can you shed some light on what Intune Suite is all about and how it benefits Windows 365 customers?
Yeah, so Windows 365 and Intune Suite works pretty good together. So Intune Suite is a cloud add-on on top of Intune and straight into the same Intune console where you also do management of Windows 365. We have some different products inside the Intune Suite. The first one is Endpoint Privilege Management. So our goal is to have customers to use least privileged account, but if they need processes and applications to run with the privileged accounts, they can do that with the EPM. We also have a backstop functionality where they can use support approved. So let's say that an end user in the financial department needs to install an application. They can ask, they can right click on the installer and ask if they're allowed to install that application. That workflow takes them into the Intune admin console where the IT admin is approving or denying that request, and we are sending the information back to the client, and then the end user can install an application. That could be reinstalling Office, it could be installing a different application on the device. And we can do that without the end user having to be a local admin on the device. We also have enterprise app management, and that is a very good fit with Windows 365. That is already a SaaS service. So enterprise app management is a SaaS service for application management. So you can go straight into the console, create an app. It will automatically generate the install parameters, the uninstall parameters, and including the app binaries as well. We can do a demo of that in a little bit. And then we have remote help, where you as an IT admin can do remote help directly into a Windows 365 device. We also have advanced analytics where you can do device query on a specific device. You can do multiple device query across your entire fleet. There's also timelines that you can go in and see if you have application crashes and so on. So a lot of new opportunity with these tools inside your toolbox.
Yeah, that's pretty cool, Per. And I love the SaaS story here, how kind of SaaS from Windows 365 comes together with SaaS from Intune and Intune Suite. A lot of customers are using Windows 365 and sometimes as well in conjunction together with Azure Virtual Desktop. So what are the differences between Intune Suite on Azure Virtual Desktop and Windows 365?
So there's some prereqs. One of them is that the AVD needs to be Intune managed. So I have created a matrix. So for Windows 365, we actually support everything. Endpoint privilege management, we are working together with your team to get AVD single session support. But you can do enterprise app management, advanced analytics, and remote help, and PKI as well. For multi-session, it's a little bit of a different story because endpoint privilege management might make sense in some scenarios, but you can break the entire device if you do something like privileged management. Enterprise application management, you can still deploy apps, you just need to do it in the device context. And remote help is on a roadmap and coming soon to your tenant if you have the license for remote help. So the story is actually pretty good, and we are working on removing the gaps that we have at the moment.
Yeah, this is great. And one of the things which you just cut out is the enterprise app management service, where you can use third-party app catalog to just search for an app and just deploy it to your cloud PC. So I think that's pretty cool. to tell as part of like simplification further versus just uploading like an installment file into like Intune and then deploy it all manually, kind of a little bit as an IT admin as well, the maintenance part. I'm curious, like, how this all looks and feels like in the Intune portal. Did you prepare some demos as well?
Yeah, so I'm not very good at the recorded demos, so I actually want to do it live. So you asked about the enterprise app management. So it's actually pretty easy. You go straight into your console. You go into the Windows. You have your apps. You create a new one. And you select an app type. We have the enterprise app catalog. You go and select an app. You start browsing the catalog. And as you can see, we have many, many apps inside our catalog. So let's just take FileZilla as one example. You can go in, you can select the app, then you will get the binaries. It will fill out all of the fields that is required to create an Win32 app inside the Intune. It will give you the install command and the uninstall command. And then you can click next. You have the requirements. Everything will be pre-filled. And you have the detection rule that we have tested, and it's actually working on your device. You can use scope tag if you have a requirement for role-based access inside Intune. And at last, you can go into assignment. And in this example, I will just take all my Windows 365 device. I have an old Windows 365 group. And then it will start installing on my Windows 365 apps. At some point in the future, you will see that you have apps that needs updates. So you have an overview of what kind of apps you need to be updating inside your environment. So you just go in and click on it. There will be a update button, and it will take you to the entire workflow of updating an app. Pretty straightforward as an IT admin. And you don't need to go out and download the binaries from anywhere in the world or from the ISVs.
Yeah, this is great. And how many apps are in this catalog right now?
Right now, we are close to 500, and we are adding more apps all the time to the catalog. Do you want to see what we can do on device query, where we can actually ask a question directly to the device on a Windows 365 that is live inside our tenant?
Let's do it.
So if I go into devices, I will find my cloud PC in here. As you can see, you have all the regular options, but with Intune Suite, you also have device query in the bottom. So let's go down and see. I will check Windows services. And if I click run, I get all the service that is actually running right now on my cloud PC. Let's say that I want to see if my Windows Defender service is running on the device. So I will just use this display name that contains, and I will say contains Defender, and then I will run it. And I get all the active services that contains Defender in the display name, and I can see that they're running. So let's say that some of them were not running. You can do remote action, and then you can do a restart of the device, or you can do a refresh. And in the future, you will also be able to run a remediation script on the device as well. So some of the things that are said about advanced endpoint analytics is that you can go into the user experience as well, and you can go in and see device timeline. Inside device timeline, you can see what happens on the device and if you have errors. So yesterday evening, I was playing around with application control for business, and I made a mistake when I did the policy deployment, and that actually caused the app crash on my EPM service, and I can go straight in here and see what actually happens on the device.
Yeah, the cool thing here is I think that you can really go deep into troubleshooting here, right? Like as an IT admin.
Yeah, and if you need the, just like I showed with the device query, if you need it for all your devices, you can go into the into multiple device query, and then you can just start asking on your entire estate. So you get information both on your cloud PC, but also on your physical PCs. We just put examples script in. So you don't need to run a and do QQL on your own. So we have example scripts that you can leverage. And if you have CoPilot in your tenant as well, on the device query, you can get CoPilot to write your QQL query for you. So you don't have to have that skill.
Yeah, I was just about to say the use of CoPilot inside the Intune portal would be a great fit here for use cases where you don't know exactly how the query looks like, that CoPilot can help you there, right?
Yeah, so I was actually in a call with a customer the other day where they were trying out the device query and they were not able to do it. So I suggested to them that they went into CoPilot and got CoPilot to help them write the QQL query, and then they got it right in the first run. So it is really beneficial, especially if you are not super good at QQL. And to be honest, I'm not the best at QQL. So CoPilot inside Intune is very helpful for me in my days.
So what are the other demos that you prepared for today?
I actually prepared endpoint privilege management as well. But there is some, when we do support approved, it takes some time. So it's actually kind of a bad demo to do live, but I will show you what we have put into the product recently. So when you have the support approved and an IT user is requesting, as you can see, I have some requests in here. One of them is actually denied. Then if I go in as an IT admin afterwards and say, yeah, I would actually allow this one to install and run on some of my devices in my environment, but I don't want the end user to go in and right click and do the support approved. So I can go straight in here. And as you can see on top of it, we can create a rule based on all the information we have here. Previously, we had to use PowerShell locally on the device to extract all the information. Now we have the file. We have all the metadata as well. We have the file hash, we have the version number and the file description. So with these information, we can create a rule. So let me create a new rule. We can define if it's going to be user confirmed, automatic, or even support approved. And we can say, to be most secure, I will not allow any child process to run with privileged access. And then I can just create a new one. So let me call it Notepad++25 and then click yes. And it's super fast. I can go over here and do a refresh. And I will have the policy I already created, and I can assign it. And I did not have to go through finding all the information. Everything is just uploaded and already in the rule, so it's ready to use. Super easy as an IT admin.
Yeah, so the benefit here is, first of all, a user doesn't have to be local administrator to install applications. Nope. Second, if they want to, but the IT admin needs to be in control of it, they can get like a prompt for asking elevated permissions, and then the IT pro gets kind of in a queue a response from a user, hey, I want to install this Notepad++ application, and then approve that as an IT pro, and then they can, with elevated privileges, install that app still without being a local administrator, right?
Still without being a local administrator, and they can leverage our least privileged approach.
Yeah, that's pretty awesome, because it really defines the zero trust principles, the security, the cloud, all coming together. And then with Defender and other kind of security products we provide to customers, it really locks down the cloud PC in the most secure way possible.
Yeah, it's super easy to use when you get started. You can even do create a policy and put it into an audit mode so you can see across your entire device estate what kind of processes need elevation over time. And then you can create your rules after that before you take the local admin rights from your end user.
So what are the other tips and tricks you have for this audience? Are there any other follow-ups or things you want to leave the audience with?
I would definitely, so if the customer has the licenses for Intune Suite, I would definitely put EPM into an audit mode, so that they can get the insights and the reporting into what kind of application is needing to be run with higher privilege than they have on their device. The second thing is I would definitely ensure that they are onboarded into endpoint analytics, and with the advanced endpoint analytics, they will start to get the data in so that they can see abnormally detection, they can see resource uses on their devices, and then they can use the device query that is actually live on their devices and multiple device query where they can do it on the entire device fleet. So I think we have some pretty awesome tools inside the Intune Suite. And also the products inside Intune Suite is pretty tied together with us having the remote help agent installed through the enterprise app management. So everything is tied together, cloud services as a SaaS service, and work together with Intune and Windows 365 as well.
This is great, Per. Great nuggets that you shared today. So thanks for hopping on, and see you soon.
Thank you for having me.